Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm John, this is Many a True Nut, and welcome back to Hitman, because we have got ourselves a brand new mission and episode and destination as well. That's right, Thailand and Bangkok are here in what I was about to call episode 4, but presumably it's not. It's presumably episode 5, because episode 4 was the summer episode, because there's 7 episodes total, and 7 is Japan and 6 is USA, so logically Bangkok must actually be episode 5. So we've kind of skipped from episode 3 to 5, because yeah, the summer episodes was episode. It's all a bit odd. It's all a bit odd, I can't deny. Sometimes episodic games get a little bit confusing. But we've got ourselves a new mission. Club 27. Let's just dive in and see what this is about, shall we?
Good morning, 47. Your destination is the Himapan Luxury Hotel Resort on the Chao Phraya River, just outside Bangkok. Your main target is Jordan Cross, the lead singer of The Class, a renowned indie rock outfit recording their highly anticipated sophomore album. But this millennial poster boy harbors a dark secret. 1 year ago, promising young actress Hannah Highmore fell to her death from Cross's penthouse loft in Dumbo, New York. According to the police, Miss Highmore's death was a tragic accident, but her parents remain unconvinced. They firmly believe that Cross murdered Hannah and only escaped justice due to the power and influence of his father, billionaire media mogul Thomas Cross. A secondary target, Ken Morgan, corporate fixer and attorney to the Cross family, is also staying at the hotel. Cunning and unscrupulous, Morgan was a key agent in the cover-up of Hannah Highmore's murder and Jordan Cross's subsequent acquittal. The Highmores understandably want retribution. And while the system may be powerless, ICA is anything but. I will leave you to prepare.
All right, so we've got ourselves two targets and no kind of third thing to do. So no, like, file to retrieve or anything of that nature. Got it. So only one starting location for now. Absolutely fine. So we've got ourselves, yes, the Riverside Landing. Obviously, we'll go over to the Silver Baller. This is nice, by the way. You've now actually got detailed descriptions of the guns. I believe this was just added by a patch. So now it actually tells you what all the little symbols mean. Because, yeah, apparently that symbol means full auto. I would never have guessed that symbol meant full auto. I don't know how that's supposed to represent full auto. To me, it kind of looks more like don't tumble dry while loaded or something. But all right, yes, you can now actually find out what all the bloody symbols actually mean. So isn't that lovely? But obviously, we'll be taking in our lovely Silver Baller. Coin, fiber wire, and smuggling in the 47th suite. Okay, so we've got a room at the hotel. Yeah, let's take in a lockpick that we can pick up. We'll have distraction items. We've got the fiber wire. I don't want to wear the casual suit. I want to wear the absolution suit because it's lovely and has gloves and everything, so it feels proper and professional. Right, let's dive in and see what we can do here, because until we've unlocked a few more, like, starting locations or drop points, and until we know what the hell's going on, there's no point really planning anything else.
Welcome to Bangkok, 47. Ken Morgan has booked the Queen Suite, but has yet to check in. You will find him in and around the restaurant. Oddly enough, Jordan Cross seems completely unaware of his presence. Cross and the Class have set up a recording studio in the Emperor's Suite on the third floor. Private security around Cross and his entourage is highly capable. Still, I'm sure you can find your way into his inner circle. After all, today is Jordan Cross's 27th birthday. The age when rock stars die. Good luck, 47.
Is it? Did a famous rock star die at 27? I'm not really a fan of rock music. I don't know. Ooh, this is very pretty, mind. Like, the new Hitman game. Oh, the water and the reflection and the bobbing of the boats and the detail and distance there. That is just lovely, mind. That is just beautiful. All right, what can we start with? Well, got ourselves various members of staff around here. That strikes me. If I get like one of these on their own, staff members, probably good point. So remember those. You are security of some description. Okay, so remember that that's there. I mean, I assume I'm allowed to just go in, because if I have a suite, which is where my lockpick is, therefore I must be a guest at the hotel. All right, let's look at the map here. So right now we're down on the lowest level. So the map is actually not really that big in terms of like its size, but it's got multiple levels. I'm excited by this one. Like, the best Hitman levels are always in like public areas, like hotels, because like military installations like the school in Marrakesh aren't actually that interesting, because like, you know, only one person's allowed really to be there for the most part, and it's soldiers, so there's like not much interesting stuff you can do there. But like when you're in a public area like a hotel, oh, it can be very, very interesting indeed. Right, Let's just go into the hotel, check in, get our lockpick, and figure out what's going on next. More just random guests, more security. Am I allowed this way? Hello? Yep, you're fine with me just wandering around. So pretty much everyone can just wander around freely on these levels around the hotel. Oh, this is pretty mind. Very, very pretty indeed. And in we go, the front door. Oh, ho-ho. Oh, guys. Oh, hello.
Brick Morgan, lawyer and corporate fixer.
Ken the Brick Morgan. Okay, so we know where you are, though in all fairness, we would have known where you were anyway, because this is not any of the elusive targets or contracts or anything, so therefore he always shows up in red and is on my map, so I can keep an eye on him very, very easily. Right, let's not worry about him just now. Let's actually just get ourselves acquainted with the hotel. Hello, I assume I can speak to you and get a key.
Yes. Checking in. Everything is name's ready for you. Tobias. Someone Reaper. Will be here right thank away to so show much, you sir. To your room.
And of course, we're back using the name Mr. Reaper. Lovely. Place. Missing note from Dexy. I don't know who Dexy is exactly. And also, there's something around the back there. I assume I'm not allowed to just walk through here. Do you mind me walking through here? Oh, yeah, okay. Yeah. No, it's fine. It's fine. This is a lovely hotel, by the way. This is just gorgeous, in fact. Love it. So, bar at the back here. Obviously, whole bunch of drinks. I assume I can blend in as a waiter. And then at the back here, I'm assuming. And then, okay, yep, that is indeed a staff area there. Again, don't go that way. So, just up the stairs onto the second floor. Doesn't look like there's an elevator.
The Himapan is the most exclusive.
Mrs. Mukchai, sir? Thomas Cross built a space station. This place isn't even a blip on his radar.
But, of course. Forgive me.
Who is Mrs. Mukchai?
Welcome, sir, to the Himapan Hotel. Do enjoy your stay.
Okay, so you just run the place, do you? Right, well, I won't be able to disguise myself as you, because you're a woman, and 47 can never disguise himself as a woman. So something else must be going on here.
You can't come through here. Sorry.
Okay, so that there must be one of, like, the private areas. So over on the second floor, we've got ourselves a target on that side. Let's instead go find our room, which I'm assuming is on the second floor. This side. Staff only that way. Fine, we'll explore that in time. I need to find 205. Okay, so the lounge here is locked off, which is what they just said. So unless I've got a key card, I will presumably be able to get off. Cross's staff can't get in here. All right. Alternatively, aha, I see. So this area is exclusive for Cross. There's a way I could get in if I've got a card, or without a card if I've got the right disguise, I can go in this way, but I'm assuming that would have to be a frisking up on the second floor. Got it. Ooh, I like this level already. This has got all the hallmarks of a really, really great Hitman level right here. Another bar, so again, some people, aha. So, poison the right drink here with just some rat poison, and the right person will have to run to the bathroom. Right person runs to the bathroom. Is this, oh, yep, this was trespassing. Fine, don't worry. So obviously we've got ourselves mop, freezer back there. Then we've got, what is that? No, just don't mind me. I just need to check what this is. I'm going to pick up a coconut. Yes, coconuts. That sounds like just the thing. And out we go. So instead, ignore the private party for now. Let's just go round, find ourselves a room. Another staff room at the back here. Oh, that just leads over here. Oh, hello.
That's Abel De Silva. He's only one of the most awesome drummers on the New York indie scene. He was in Death and Taxes and Flat Earth Society.
Yeah. I like Top 40.
Anyway, De Silva's filling in for the drummer in Jordan Cross's band who quit yesterday. The record label flew him in, and I took him up to the restaurant lounge. Miss Barrett, the manager, she's gonna come back.
Gee, I guess I should get his autograph.
You don't deserve his autograph. You deserve poop in a bag.
I'm not even sure who was actually saying that, by the way. I genuinely don't know who was saying that, but okay, so a drummer who's brand new, who potentially Jordan Cross would not recognize in somewhere in the hotel. So he might be able to take care of that. Oh, I'm guessing it was you two that were having that conversation. I just had no idea where that conversation was taking place. Okay, we've got ourselves nice private dining quarters around here. Might be able to get myself a nice staff disguise from you. Don't know if anyone else would come around this way if I would just kind of like to hide your body somewhere around here out of the way. Fine. And then back downstairs, and okay, so this is back to reception. So going to the right of the top there just brings you in a big loop round to, like, the restaurant. Obviously, we've got ourselves a lot of chef, food, things, cooking pots, all of that good stuff. So all the kitchens round the back. And then, aha, a bathroom at the rear. Now, this is perfect. So obviously, a bathroom is an excellent place. Take people out, stash bodies, something, something. And I'm guessing very conveniently, in fact. Hang on, no. Don't mind me. I'm just going to very quickly get you down at this point. Yep, there we are, as you literally are right here. Let's just grab you and put you in the very convenient wardrobe that no one ever checks. Nice. So, kitchen staff. It's a good disguise to start off with anyway. None of you guys can. Someone in the kitchens can. Obviously, the kitchen guys know what the other kitchen staff look like, which is fine. I'll just keep my distance from them for a moment. This guy actually comes in here and is around the restaurant. Let's just keep an eye on him. What do you do? Oh, hello. Are you by any chance about to have a nibble off one of these little plates? Did you? Yes. Yes, you do. Well, that makes killing you remarkably easy if I can just get some rat poison, because you are in a loop and you just took a nibble off. Which one was it? This one here? Pretty sure it was this one here. Okay. The first in after the first little separator on the left there. Got it. Just go and get some rat poison. We're in good shape. Now, staff door right here, wasn't it? Yes, staff area. Now, I'm staff, so this is no longer trespassing. Lovely. What is this? This is the... Oh. Back area of the kitchen. Right, let's just sneak around the back of these guys and see what else is going on here. So there's a little basement area around the back. In fact, I thought I was already on the lowest floor. What floor am I on now, then? Oh, I see. Sorry. Technically, level zero where you start is kind of the basement. Okay, so there's a whole little basement area here as well. Got it. So this is a back way in if you don't want to go in the front door. Well, if there's one place I'm going to be able to get something like rat poison, this strikes me as a good sort of area for that. And I've been recorded on a security camera. Never mind, we'll fix that later. So stairs go up, and that leads me out here to the very side. Okay, so the stairs at the side that lead down into the kitchen. Got it. With a view over a very, very beautiful beach indeed. You know, you should really be helping that woman. She does not look comfortable. Ah, and there's also a window from the side here that means you can hop into the side of the restaurant too. Got it. Right, let's go down here. I totally want to just go and get myself some rat poison from this area, which there totally is going to be. Oh, but not if I get spotted first. Okay, down here. Oh, you're just some sort of senior security person, aren't you? A coconut. Yes, perhaps, my good sir, you would like to investigate a coconut.
What?
What? That sounded like a coconut. All right, get you down nice and quick. And there was a box right here, wasn't there? Yes, there was. Right, grab you and shove you in here. And I think you look more like senior security to me because you've got a fancier hat than everyone else, which would work very, very nicely. Hotel security. Let's give that a go, see how that goes. And that works pretty well. No one seems to be... Oh, one person right there. See, okay, fine. It looks like, whoa, I feel like I'm wearing a fancier hat. I should be like a captain or something, but sadly, doesn't seem to be the case. Never mind, let's go back into just kitchen staff. That works much better, lovely. Now, gotta find myself some rat poison down here. This is a back area, it's totally gonna be around here somewhere. Well, got myself a crowbar, always worth collecting a full set of tools. Here we are, rat poison right in the next room, and a screwdriver as well, perfect. That is two very useful bits and pieces. All right, first things first then, let's actually go and sort out the first guy. Because if we've got one guy down here who I can deal with super easily through rat poison, I may as well test out just how easy that is. So, where's the man? No, just hold up for a second. I have to add the secret special ingredient. Need to add the secret ingredient. Turn away. Oh, damn it. Wait, has he gone for a different one this time? Oh, does he go for them at random? That'd be irritating if he did. Right. Chef is now looking away. I know this guy does eat from this meal. I'm allowed to add some special ingredients to this. No trouble. Let's check where you go now. Let's just follow him. And we've now got some poison on that food, so if he does always eat from that one, I was just mistaken, that would be useful to know.
Has a message come through for me yet?
No, Mr. Morgan, no messages.
We're off to a flying start. Is my suite ready yet?
Housekeeping is hard at work, sir. I'm sure it won't be long now.
Okay. So his suite presumably never gets finished or anything, which is fine. And then I just quickly run out of the door before they see me. Nice. Anyone out here going to see me? Nope, no one's going to see me. So has he got actually a very, very small loop? His loop is literally just... He goes to front desk, can't check in, goes out here, looks out at sea or something, then goes back into the restaurant and nibbles on a plate of food. Because if so, he is... That's a remarkably simple small loop. Although first, a phone call. Let's learn a bit more about the plot here.
Mr. Cross, I have arrived. Damp, bright, French colonial, the river smells of fish. No, truly, of fish. I look forward to leaving. So, your son's manager, this Dexy Barrett. Anything I should know? Not a problem. I know the type. No, no, we'll meet on the QT. We don't want Jordan to know I'm here. He might throw a fit and sway Miss Barrett from doing the smart thing. Think nothing of it. Some things need to be handled in person. It is only the semi-finals, after all. I will call you from the airport. Only the semi-finals.
So Cross wants to do some business with Dexy. So if I get Dexy's note and put it onto that little train reception, he gets the note and that presumably interrupts this very small loop he's on right now. He goes into a separate loop. But on this particular occasion, I'm not sure he's ever going to get there because I don't know where that note is, and hopefully he's about to go and eat himself some poison fish. Come on, turn right, turn right, turn right, turn right. Is that the right plate? No, he's gone for a flipping different one this time. I think he genuinely does go for them slightly at random. I tell you what, that's actually a nice addition that it is semi-randomized, because it is slightly ridiculous that, like, you know, normally in loops, they always drink from the same glass. They always eat exactly the same thing. There's no variety at all. So, you know what? We're going to need more rat poison. Right, deeper into the basement, and this is a good way to move around if you're disguised as staff, though security cameras down here. We've got ourselves another little way up. This leads up to, this is presumably the rear of the hotel. Yes, this is the rear of the hotel. Got it. And is that, yep, that is some more rat poison. Lovely. Okay, rat poison, a second dish. Now half the dishes are rat poisoned. Come on, go to the right, go to the right, go to the right, go to the, damn it! Oh, hello, what have we got here? Master key card. Grab that. I just got a key card down here in the laundry in the basement. Perfect. That there, very, very useful. And some bonus coins. Obviously, people had coins left over in their pockets. Good, and that is a wrench down there if you need one. Got it. And also, something else down here. Manage note on the Queen Suite emergency. A Queen Suite emergency. Members of Young Master Cross's sound crew broke into the Queen Suite and sullied it after housekeeping was finished. Mr. Morgan, our esteemed guest and representative, our owner Thomas Cross. Ah! Okay, so if I'm disguised as a member of housekeeping, I can escort him up to the Queen's suite and then potentially have him on his own. Okay, interesting. All right, this time, go right, go to the right, head to the right, that's right, bear to the right, to the right, oh, that's right, to the 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 right, not the left, to the right. Yes! Okay, now, get around the back here. I think he's about to start feeling sick and running to the bathroom. There we go, and we've got ourselves a bathroom right here. Why don't you go...
Keep your distance.
Wait, hang on. Oh, he's not going to the bathroom I was expecting. Which bathroom is he going to? He totally looks uncomfortable. Oh, very clever, game. Very clever indeed. Fine, not quite as easy as I was expecting. Presumably he doesn't just do that forever, he does actually just recover and return to his normal routine at some point, right? That would make sense. Okay, plan B then. We need to find a male member of housekeeping in order to get ourselves a disguise. Or, alternatively, I could just say screw all of that, run past this here and use that master key card I've got to go over and activate this door, which isn't even a crime. So that is now open. All right, who's actually in here? Hello. Let's just go in here and take a nice... Yep, there we are. So no one's in here right now. Fine, what are we looking at? But one guard right there, bit of a problem. Someone on the... Who are you? Oh, I think you could be one of the people we've been, had mentioned to us. Hang on. Now, whose attention to that? Yes. I think you are the drummer we've had mentioned to us. And subdue you. I don't think anyone else is going to be coming in here, actually. Yes, Abel de Silva, the new drummer, who apparently nobody knows what he looks like. Grab the coin as well, just in case. Grab him and move him round the back. I want to say round the back. Not really that round the back, but presumably... Oh, when I say nobody will know what he looks like, everybody knows what he looks like. Oh dear. Right, well, this isn't necessarily going to work that well, then, is it? Whereas if I'm just normal staff, I am... Am I even allowed to be in here? Is this allowed? Oh, yes. This is fine. Staff are just allowed to be in here in the lounge. Got it. And then this is just a bar area exclusively for his staff. Okay. May as well get myself a knife while I'm here. And pop that away too. Couple of glasses.
Every night. Have you not heard?
Oh, a heavy sleeper. Look, I always have been.
Well, I'm telling you. Every night in his room, Cross listens to this recording. A man and a woman fighting horribly over and over again.
Oh, come on. He's just watching TV, one of those, one of those Scandinavian dramas where the people are having hissy fits in their kitchens and shit.
He's not watching TV, but I recognize the woman's voice from TV. It's Hannah Highmore.
Cross's dead girlfriend, the one who... fell from the roof?
No, the other one. Of course, that dead girlfriend. Cross is listening to a recording of himself and Hannah Highmore fighting.
What the... That's what... Well, okay, well, does it end with a scream?
Dunno, but there's a struggle. Then he stops and rewinds.
Come on, you listen to yourself. You're taking a piss, man.
Okay, that's creepy as anything. Let's give a go with the drummer, see what we can do here. Down this way, straight across this way... And presumably I'm allowed to just, as I'm the drummer, I'd be allowed to go through to where Cross is, right? Hello, you're fine with me, right? Hello?
Mr. De Silva?
Yes! Okay, they don't recognize me. The entourage does, but these guys do not. And then we've got ourselves a... Is this a staff area? Yes, I am indeed technically trespassing in a staff area. Just get rid of that quickly. So why aren't I allowed back here? So now, no one here recognizes... I don't know why all the people in the party recognize me. Well, I guess it just makes sense they recognize me. It makes sense because they saw me just a minute ago. Just, that's not normally how Hitman works. So it feels like maybe they've slightly tweaked the AI to make, you know, more bloody sense. So, 101... Actually, that's a good point. I haven't actually so far managed to... Why is it the feeling with that distinctive hair? You are Dexy.
Hi, Abel. How are you?
Also, I never actually found a way to get 47 up to his suite, which is interesting. So we've got swipe card, but presumably... Oh yeah, I've got the master key. I can get in literally every room because I have the master key. Nice. Okay, so we can check if there's anything interesting going on in any of these rooms. Not particularly, but I can't deny these are beautiful, lovely rooms indeed. So yeah, now I can get to every room in the hotel. So down in the basement, the master card key in the laundry, that there is very, very... Security room! This is the room. Luckily, swiping only takes a second, so... No one... Oh, hello. Hello. Someone apparently can see through my disguise. Who can? Who can see through my disguise? Who was that? Ah, this is interesting. A lethal poison... No, don't do that. Oh, never mind. We've just overflowed a sink. I didn't even mean to do that. A lethal poison pill jar right here. Good, good, good. So that was in room 104 up on the first floor, a little bit out of the way. So just kind of round the corner. Now, I'm guessing this room here is the one where he'll be staying in, right? Well, it only says 102, whereas I know he booked like a Queen exclusive something-something suite. But that is also a location where we could be getting ourselves housekeeping if we wanted to be housekeeping. And being housekeeping could potentially be very, very useful. And then finally, this room over here. Ah, that's the security room again. So, whenever I want to eventually get rid of security footage, it's up here on the first floor. Let's head up to the next floor. I must be allowed everywhere. I'm the flipping drummer. If I'm in the band, I feel like I should be allowed everywhere. That's the person you will be seeing through my disguise. Someone over there knows who I am. Got it. So now we're up on the second floor. And this entire flipping floor appears to have been pretty much trashed by these guys. Lovely. Including the fact that I believe they've... Have they moved the flipping bath? Where does this go? Hang on. Yes! They've decided to move the bath out to here. Of course they have. Bloody rock stars, eh? So whoever you are, you appear to actually be able to recognize me for some reason. Would you mind just popping over there for a second so I can just sneak around the back of you?
What?
And now finally this room at the back I can now sneak into. Oh, yep, and everyone's enjoying a nice sheesh pipe.
The letter, Neil. The one Dexie Barrett told you to take down to reception 3 hours ago?
All right. No, I'm good, thanks. I'll pop down in a moment.
Yeah, so you keep saying.
You can. Dexie Barrett is Jordan's manager. He's not the boss of us.
Who's the note for, anyway?
She didn't say. But he's staying at the Queen's Suite, so I figure he's someone important.
You totally have a note, don't you?
I will. In a minute.
And it's this guy who's saying it. There we are. Let's just get you down nice and quick. And just round the back of the tub here. You have totally got a letter on you, don't you? Disguise recording crew. You must have dropped it over. Yep. Here we are. One note from Dexie. So I can't actually see what that message is, but clearly I'm supposed to drop the message off there and potentially follow Ken Morgan around as a result. Lovely. So, up on the second floor, and we've got a surprise birthday party for this guy. And apparently I'm allowed to tamper with the cake. He's 27, it's his birthday. No one minds me being here if I'm the drummer, and I can tamper with the cake as much as I want because it's not got the little warning triangle next to it. So, I do have those murder pills here. Murder pills seems like a good sort of thing to slip in the cake. Right, tamper the birthday cake. Yep, add the poison. Oh, apparently that is a problem. All right, fine. Well, I'm just going to run out of here very quickly now. And you're all going to forget about seeing someone add pills into the cake, right? I bet you all flipping are.
I still got it. He probably went crying home to his mommy.
Yep, they've decided they no longer care about the bloke who blatantly added pills to the cake. He's now going to head back to his original position and everything is now fine. So that's definitely not going to be Silent Assassin, but whatever. I'm not going for Silent Assassin on my first go. I'm just kind of wanting to set up as many fun little accidents as I can. So, he's going to go back to there in a second. Yep, he goes back into the party room, which is over there. Presumably, as I'm part of the band, I'm allowed to go up to the top floor, right?
How are you?
Yep, fine. Top floor without being frisked or anything, so therefore I've now got guns. No one up here spots anything. So, the Emperor's Suite... And we've got ourselves, yep, he's in there. Beautiful. Then we've got ourselves over here. This is a staff area, but I'm allowed to be here anyway. So I can be in here and no one seems to mind me being here at all. Because obviously, yeah, no one's met me. It's, yeah, it was only those guys in that one room where you pick him up who can see through the disguise. Everyone else, like, this seems to be a pretty much perfect disguise being the drummer.
Who's this? Oh, hey, you're Quentin's replacement, right? Yeah, thanks for coming out.
And can we just... follow you somewhere? Can I can't talk to him. So, what do you want me to do?
Everyone, this is Abel De Silva. He's here to take over for Quentin.
Hello.
Good to go.
Cool. So, what do you say, man? Get behind the kid, show us what you're made of.
I don't know if 47 knows how to use the drums, but alright, I will in just a second. Alright, I'll attempt to play the drums. I don't know how, but let's see how 47 does.
For a particular vocal sound that only he and a handful of people in the world will ever notice?
As I say, uncompromised. Anyway, it's safe enough when you know how to handle it. Just don't crank the voltage.
All right, well, I'll keep that in mind.
Yeah!
Apparently, I vaguely know what I'm doing.
Yeah, man. Yeah, that was cool. All right, you're like some kind of machine, aren't you? Oh, man, nicely done. Why don't you walk with me, Abe? There's something I want to show you.
After you.
That'd be beautiful. Let's walk to a quiet environment where there's no bodyguards, ideally where you're right over a ledge that falls directly into water, because that there, that'd be magnificent.
Yeah, so, sorry about the mood around here. Heidi's still pissed about Quentin leaving, but yeah, just don't expect her to roll out the red carpet. So just do your thing, do it well, and she'll soften up.
It's fine. Where are we going?
Atrium roof. Look, I want to pitch you something, and I don't want the others to hear. Bad for morale.
Okay, atrium roof. I don't even know how we get there, but all right. Oh, through the security office, is it? Okay, because this is the... Oh, no. No. Oh, I didn't even realize these were flipping doors here. All right, beautiful. So he's still got two bodyguards with him. So I can't just murder him out here, because people are still around and they can still see. And there's a flipping gardener up here, too.
Okay, people, clear the roof. Mr. Cross needs his privacy.
Aha! Nice. So the gardeners are clearing out. He said his guards there facing the wrong way. Perfect.
So, you should talk to Dexy when we get back to New York. Who's repping you?
Small agency. Very low profile. You wouldn't have heard of them.
Oh, buddies from school, huh? Don't have the heart to let them go? Yeah, I thought so. Look, believe me, man. You gotta aim higher. Anyway, so I have this project coming up, and I think it's right up your alley.
Going solo?
Yeah, that's the plan. I could use a solid drummer.
A hired gun, not a partner. Someone who does the job without getting noticed.
Oh, so you're interested?
It's what I do.
Great, yeah. Oh, mull it over. Talk to your people if you have any. You can decide when we get back to New York.
Perfect. Off you go, by the way. Oh, and I think this is about to go. Oh, what a tragic accident that was. Oh, dear. Perfect. Challenge completed. You're so fly. Nice. I'm going to guess that was indeed an accident because he just fell off the roof and totally not my fault. Not my problem in the slightest. Yep, someone could hurt themselves. That means that is an accident kill. Lovely. There is one small problem, though, which is that body is now, like, right in the position where it's going to get potentially spotted by the other guys. So, interesting. Let's actually cut across the roof, by the way, because I don't actually know how you get up onto the second floor normally. How'd you get up here under normal circumstances? I generally don't know, because this is the, this is 47's room right here, 205. So I can use this one, though I've got the master, even though I didn't have the master. So this here's my suite. So presumably somewhere in here I've got my... Oh, hello. Trespassing? I'm not trespassing. This is flipping 47 suite. Though actually, I guess I'm not 47 right now. I'm the drummer. So the drummer's kind of trespassing. Got myself a letter opener as well. That's always welcome. So just leave this room right here. And yeah, we're now on the other... Like, where's the staircase up to here? Second floor. Where's the staircase that leads up to this one? This is... Oh! I walked straight past this earlier, I just completely missed it. So, okay, the way to get up to 47 room is just to go right off the entrance and then up again. Sorry, I just completely overlooked that first time I was here. Now, I'm guessing this side of the hotel will probably find... That's the Red Admiral Lounge. Here's just a bunch of rooms. If I could find the Queen Something Suite... Hello, what's this one? I'm allowed to do this. I'm guessing going in here you consider a problem, but... Let's just go in here. Hello. Walk on the wild side. What is going on in this room? I don't know. There's two people in here, though. Including recording crew. Ah, there's just some recording crew in here. Right, so if you want a recording crew uniform, breaking into room... Which one is this? This is room 207, using the master key card and laundry. You've got the recording crew uniform right here in the bathroom. Nice. And yes, indeed, someone just kind of completely fallen over and some woman... Who's taking photos of him? Dear, oh dear, that's a little bit on the rude side. Let's hit the clock radio, shall we? There we are. I assume that gets him up and about so he can no longer have photos taken of him. Nice. Oh dear. I may have just slightly upset someone there. Okay, never mind. Okay, now get rid of you two. Right. Oh, well, that was a bit messy. This wasn't signed to us. Oh, dear. Right, okay, we're going to need some more people getting out of the way in a second. Yeah, why don't you just come over here? And there we go. Stop coming in this room. Now, what exactly was your deal, by the way? You had, you're guarding a couple of coins. Fine, but other than that, you're not actually, oh, hello, what's this? A-O. This is where you get a Branson MD2 microphone. A production defect makes this short circuit at high voltages, so go into 207, grab this microphone, you can take it up to the top floor, swap it out for the microphone that's actually in the recording studio, and then just if you're a recording crew, you can then whack up the voltage by interfering with one of the kind of the machines that's floating around, and with that, ooh, a golf club as well, lovely. That's not visibly armed, alright? A golf club is not a weapon, well not exclusively anyway. But you know what, this is fine, because now I can be hotel staff. And hotel staff is actually what I want to be if I am going to get Mr. Cross. No, not Mr. Cross. The other one. Ken. Ken the Brick something or another. Ken Morgan. That was him. That's what I'm going to be if I need to get... Oh, hello. Am I supposed to be here? Who are you, by the way? Is this just more recording staff? No, that's just some random holiday maker. Fine. But as I'm hotel staff, I'm allowed to be in this room. Very good. Now, can I go up to the third floor? As staff? I'm assuming so. Staff feel like they should be able to go everywhere, that's fair.
House staff? Yeah, you're clear.
Good, good. House staff, absolutely fine. So third floor now on this side. We got ourselves, oh, I see. Third floor, of course, isn't divided in half like the others are. Third floor is just everything's the same, right? Oh, no, no, it's not. I'm completely mistaken. That is 100% wrong. It is still divided in two. So the recording studio's on the other side, and I'm now in what is presumably the... Penthouse Queen! This is his apartment. Perfect. Perfect, perfect, perfect. So, I've got the swipe card, of course. That lets me over here into this kitchen area. Got to be a bit careful here because somebody in here can see through my disguise. But this is his suite, or rather, this is the kitchen attached to his suite, I guess. As housekeeping, I can go up to Ken Watts's face and presumably go and grovel to him. Okay, and that will get him to follow me up to this suite where presumably, say in the bathroom, there'll be a good chance to kill him. So, let's just go over to the nice man here and say hello to him. Hello!
Mr. Morgan, sir.
When can I have my suite?
Please accept my heartfelt apology.
I think I heard the servant bell.
For the mishap earlier. The Queen's suite is ready for you. Follow me.
Well, that was relatively fast. Very well, lead the way.
Gladly, assuming we can avoid anyone who might theoretically recognize me, because if we do, I might need to just ever so slightly dive out of the way of those people. Sorry if so, sir.
Oh, I could do with a cup of tea.
I don't blame you. Your boss has just died in a tragic roof accident.
Hmm. A definite improvement. Hardly the Bourge al Arab. Let's take a closer look.
And now, presumably, he will tour. And if we're lucky, he'll leave his bodyguard behind while he's doing it. And I just need to avoid the one person who can see through my disguise, wherever she is.
See there? A smear. As expected. But take care of it, please. So sloppy.
Is he actually waiting for me to do it? Because if so, I'll totally do it.
Well, if you're not going to clean, we might as well call it a day, shall we? Rest assured that I am going to brief Mr. Cross thoroughly on how his investment is being managed. Good day.
So he now is going to, what, head straight back downstairs again? Potentially so, yes. Okay, fine. So he's not happy with what he saw, so he heads back downstairs. Now, what's actually upstairs at the top floor of this place? Because there's an entire another floor here I missed last time I was here. Including a roof garden. Oh, that's snazzy. I like that.
Oh, sorry, sir. I'm in the middle of something, and you need to leave.
Okay. Or, alternatively, one of the other rock stars is in this bathroom. Got it. Sorry, I thought this was all his. Yep, and he returns to his original loop. Now, let's get that letter in the thing and see if we can just do that nice and quick.
I found this on the stairs. It says Queen Suite on the envelope.
I see.
Very well, I'll take care of it.
Any messages for me?
Yes, there's a message right there, in fact, would you believe?
Let me check. Yes, Mr. Morgan. A letter was only just delivered. Here you are, sir.
Finally. Basement linen room. call me when you get there. Dexie Barrett.
Ah.
Let's go.
Okay.
Dexie Barrett finally gave word. We're meeting at the linen room.
Hmm.
Welcome to the exciting world of corporate underhand dealings.
Now, presumably this will be a very good time to get rid of one of these guys. Yes, yes indeed. Okay. Just wait for one of them to go the long way around. Yeah, he's heading down there. Let's get his bodyguard out of the picture nice and quick.
Huh.
Nice. All right, that's the bodyguard taken care of. There we go. Nice and simple. Assuming people can't see through these windows, which they probably can, actually. Actually, he had a unique disguise on him. That specifically just said Morgan's bodyguard. I'll tell you what, I'll have it. Presumably Morgan sees through that, though. Yeah, Morgan sees through that. In fact, everyone sees through that. Let's not even bother. Now, round to the linen room where we've already been, of course. That's where the master key card was. And you, my good man, are right here.
Mrs. Ken Morgan. I'm at the linen room, as requested. What do you mean that was 3 hours ago? The receptionist said the note only just arrived. Never mind. I'm here now. Just bring me the flash drive, Miss Barrett, and I promise I will be out of your hair. Tonight? Out of the question, I would need to change my flight. I have my housekeeper watching my dog.
Flash drive is totally the recording, isn't it? The recording of the screams. Bye-bye! You're getting garrotted, and then I'm going to take you back over here. And ideally, finding... Can I put you into the laundry bins? I hope so, otherwise... Aha! Even better, a definite thing we can use. In here, in you go. Dumpy dump. Lovely, lovely. Nice. Now, where are the exits? Only two so far. Looks like a little side entrance out of the basement or out of the front door. Let's be classy. Let's take the boat out. There we are. Straight past and out. So there's another door over to the left as you enter to get through into the basement. Little kind of tunnels there. But instead, let's just go straight past that. Out to the boat because let's go for a nice, pretty ending here. Beautiful. Ah, good level. Well done, guys. Bloody good level. Obviously nowhere near Silent Assassin. Lots of trouble, especially in 207 when I was kind of knocking out the multiple people there. But other than that, I should have a lot of points for this, so we should have a lot of unlocks. Ooh, and more story.
The body of billionaire media mogul Thomas Cross was discovered earlier this evening, slain by multiple gunshot wounds. Cross was scandalously kidnapped this morning at the funeral of his only son, acclaimed rock musician Jordan Cross. A notorious recluse, Thomas Cross has not left his private life in years, and authorities are now looking into the connection between the two games.
Cross had billions in hidden offshore accounts, all stripped clean within hours of the kidnapping. Someone wanted the son dead to lure out the father. Someone smart enough to stay in the shadows while we did the wet work and the Highmores picked up the check.
A shadow client. Someone got rich. The contract was just. That was a sound problem.
I know you don't care about politics, 47, but ICA is neutral, always has been. Can't allow ourselves to be manipulated. Besides...
It's happened before.
Italy. Morocco. Paris. All our clients got their intel the same way. Anonymous tips from a hidden source. Each contract perfectly legit. Yet part of a grander design.
I don't see the pattern.
Somebody does. The board has asked us to chase down this shadow client, and our analysts are closing in as we speak.
I know that tone.
Someone's playing a game, 47. The question is... Queen's tomb.
So not much more new information there, but there we are, chef's table, all aboard. Piano man, someone could get hurt on the house, how may I serve you? All of the flipping thing, going straight up to multiple levels here. The rock star, the lawyer, you're so fly, straight up to level 6. So, undercover by the security shed, starting locations, ooh, a penthouse drop off and a large machete thing, okay. We've got ourselves a large machete weapon. And a pretty poor score, obviously. That was incredibly slow because I was kind of looking everywhere and indeed all sorts of problems. So we've now got a large agency drop-off over in the penthouse and a large agency pickup over in the garden shed as well, actually. That's one area we didn't actually go to. And as for starting locations, we can start up in the suite already or we can be in hotel security by the security shed, which I'm assuming is again at the rear. Lovely. Alternatively, we could be undercover at the bar. Okay, so straight away disguised as the barman. That is the gardener, presumably. Ooh, undercover in the second floor hallway as recording staff. That's useful. Alternatively, as in the linen room as one of the actual hotel staff or as a chef in the restaurant kitchen. Beautiful. And there's our new weapon, a large suspicious machete. I'm honestly not sure why I'd ever want that, really. Actually, is that the first... throwable? No, I've already got the combat knife. Yeah, I'm not really sure why that's any different to the combat knife, really. It's just, feels just a lot less subtle. But, never mind. All right, we've got a machete now. Obviously, that's only level 6. There's a lot more to get yet. So there you are, ladies and gentlemen. That's my first little go-through of Hitman's Thailand level. Obviously, we'll have a bit more Hitman at some point later this week. I'll probably kind of have a dig through, see if there's like some fun alternative opportunities, or if it's more interesting to kind of have a look at the story. I feel like there's a little bit more story here than what I'm aware of. Like, I think we figured out much of it, which is kind of like it feels like he listens to the recording of his ex-girlfriend, Hannah Highmore, the argument just before she died, and potentially the fixer is trying to get hold of that recording and Dexy can get it for him. I'm guessing that's what's happening, but I feel like we might be able to find a little bit more yet. So I'll have a dig through, I'll have a figure out what's the best video to do next, and there'll be a bit more Hitman coming up later, ladies and gentlemen. But in the meantime, I've been John, this has been many a true nut, and this has been Hitman Episode 4 and or 5, Thailand. Thank you very much, and goodbye. Good dodge. Good dodge, man. Question is, can you keep it up, cop? Oh, no, you can't. Ooh, nice. Oh, didn't quite get that one, though. We are going to the gun store in style. Oh, where's my partner? Oh, he's not here. Oh, so long, loser.